Hey everybody, I'm Mary Taylor from Mary Taylor Weddings and Mary Taylor Photography. I am a current bride, a photographer, and a retoucher. I do a little bit of blogging as well, so that's why I started Mary Taylor Weddings. Mary Taylor Weddings is all about helping current brides plan their wedding from a bride's perspective. Although I'm a photographer, most of my blogs are coming mainly from the perspective of myself. My wedding is in September 2019. A little bit about me and my background. So I met my fiance in London just over a year and a half ago, actually, and we have been engaged since last May. I've been planning the wedding from New Zealand, where we currently live, and my fiance is a Kiwi. So planning the wedding, and we live in New Zealand, and the wedding will be in California, where I'm from. So a lot going on, and really interesting. So I've learned a lot about the process of wedding planning through planning my own wedding, but I actually always wanted to be a wedding planner. So at the age of probably 13, I just told my mom, you know, I really want to be a wedding planner, and I would buy books and magazines with my babysitting money, and then I went down the route of photography and marketing and have a business degree. So I'm kind of lost touch with the idea of being a wedding planner, but now that I'm planning my own wedding, I found that passion again, and the passion to really teach brides about planning their wedding and helping them through the process. So that's kind of what I'm here to do, and I'm here just to give, you know, my experience and my knowledge in the wedding industry in order to help current brides. So I also want to tell you my top tip. So my top tip for planning your wedding is stay organized. This can be through checklists, binders, you know, Word documents, something, but try to keep it all in one place. So I actually created a checklist because I couldn't find anything like it. And Robbie, my fiance, and I had been searching for a wedding planning book. And it was a little bit difficult for us, I have to admit, because some things just had too much words, too many words, you know? There was pages and pages on, you know, what color schemes go together and ideas for cake designs. And those are all great. However, that's not what I was looking for. I was looking for one source to include all the information, so I wasn't writing on pieces of paper all over our house, which I ended up doing until I created my wedding checklist. And my checklist has everything that I believe you actually need to plan a wedding. So all the little things that people might forget, as well as planning your budgets and when payments are due, when you've paid them, so you have a written record all in one place of these things. It also includes a last minute bridal survival kit, I guess. So what to bring on the day of that you might not think of, like a mini sewing kit or, you know, chapstick or extra lip gloss, tape, pens, all your contracts. You want all of that available to bring on your wedding day. And you also want to be able to give all of the contact information for your vendors to someone else so that you're not the one who needs to be called constantly, and you can just relax and enjoy your day. And if someone says, oh, I need to talk to the photographer, what's her information or what's his information? You have one pamphlet that has everybody's information, you give it to the important people, and you say, you deal with it. I'm going to enjoy my day. So that is another tip that I have, is, you know, have other people help you, you know, help you throughout the process, but also help you on the day of, which is where a wedding planner or a wedding coordinator comes into play. And I'm gonna do another video with Michelle, who is a wedding expert, and we are gonna talk about the differences between a day of coordinator and a wedding planner. And both are really useful, and a lot of groups on Facebook are really useful as well for helping you to get started. But when it comes down to the last minute things and the day of things, definitely put your responsibilities on someone else, because it'll help you enjoy your day so much more. Next, I'm going to talk about what to start with. So in my opinion, you should start with budgeting. And budgeting kind of includes a lot. So it does include, you know, how many people do you think that you're gonna want to invite, because that does factor into your budget significantly. The time of day, is it a weekend, is it a weekday? those types of things. The date also has to do with budgeting. So pretty much everything actually has to do with budgeting. So start with a budget and maybe your rough idea of what you want for your wedding. And if you have no idea what you want, you have no idea the time of year, the time of day, the time of the week, how many guests, anything. You don't have any idea of anything, that's okay. That's actually a good thing in a way, because you can then just start with your budget. How much money do we have in our savings or from other sources? So if your parents are gonna be contributing, things like that. How much money do you have now, and how much money could you save in order to get the amount of money that you need to have the wedding that you want? So my number one is start with budgeting. And I have a blog about that as well on my website, which definitely check out. And also in link with that is my most recent blog, which is about saving money online. So online shopping can be really great. And I personally am biased against this, I guess, because I've had to do all my wedding shopping online, just because we're having our wedding overseas. And I found some really useful ways to save money. Definitely look out on my blog and follow me on Facebook. And if you'd like to interact with me one-on-one, if you're not already a part of DIY Bridal Academy, definitely like them on Facebook, because we are doing some amazing things with collaborators and contributors, and we are going to be building up a network that is unbelievable for brides and for vendors. So like them on Facebook, and they're also connected with Weddings, Wine, and DIY. So that is actually the group where I'm going to be participating in as a collaborator and as a contributor. So you'll see my content, you'll get content that necessarily isn't on my Facebook page, and you'll also get one-on-one connections and interactions with me and the other collaborators and contributors, which are wedding professionals. So that's really important for you to be able to ask wedding professionals their opinion, not just other brides. You can look out for lots more blogs, lots more content, and hopefully podcasts in the future. So everyone have a great weekend and enjoy your wedding planning experience. I'm so excited to work with you guys.